welcome on this lovely evening to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove takeover of the vote here on Latest TV. It's lovely to have you with us. Yes, hello.
It's almost takeaway because we keep doing food, don't we?
We do have a couple of shows last time. We do have a very strong food theme.
We do. Do you book the guests, Debs?
I have certain things I'm interested in that might
Two things, food and drink.
Food and drink, yes, in that order.
Basic. So who's the food element this show?
We are very lucky to have a returning guest. We do have returning guests, so you do come back.
He fed you before, did he? And he's going to feed you again.
He actually has.
I was joking. The benefit
of his cooking. And to tell us more about what he gets up to, we have Paul Couchman from the Regency Townhouse. Welcome back. So you're from stunning Regency Townhouse.
Indeed. Well, you know from yourself.
I've had the benefit of going to one of your amazing Dine Like a Servant events.
Could you get rid of her afterwards, or was she just lurking?
She did loiter a bit. She went eventually. When the drink ran out, actually.
Oh, right. Okay. We just know you well, Debs.
So what's happening? What's new? What's the update? Tell us everything.
We're carrying on. We're done like a servant. So you came quite recently. Mm-hmm. We've got another one planned for September, which is already sold out.
You managed to restock it after Deb's last visit. Okay.
Yeah. It did. It sold out within 3 days, which is wonderful. Quite a record.
Yes.
So the next one is a Halloween special.
Oh, wow.
I'll talk about that later.
Great. Because to anyone who doesn't know, the Regency Townhouse, the way that you fundraise is through your events. You have lunch with the curator, Nick, who's been on here before. Right. You have your Dine Like a Servant events. And I went along to Dine Like a Servant. And everyone said to me, oh, are you going to like be eating sort of slops and gruel and kind of vegetable shavings? I was like, I don't know what I'm going to be eating. But what I discovered once I got there...
You didn't care.
As I was saying, what I discovered once I got there was that actually the servants back in the Regency period ate very well because The cooks would make lots and lots of lovely food for the main house, but the servants got to eat it as well. Is that correct? Did I get the right end of the stick? Absolutely correct.
I mean, it's quite nice. There's a whole cycle of food going through the house. You start off in the dining room. Mm-hmm. The cook, the housekeeper, and the butler had first dibs at what was on the sideboard. So the sideboard was never eaten by the people around the table. Mm-hmm. They'd get that. So if any of the guests touched what was on the sideboard, they'd get told off.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Or at least, but in looks, you can imagine.
It's a real hierarchy.
Yes.
So the food that didn't get eaten would end up downstairs. Mm-hmm. The servants would eat it. Also in hierarchy. Mm-hmm. So it would work its way down the servant hierarchy. Mm-hmm. And end up also going to the streets back, behind the townhouse, into the mews alley for the poor.
Yeah.
And then it would go to the pigs.
So why did they make so much then? Is it just to feed everyone?
It really is excess. Yeah. They wanted to show off how much money they had and how much taste they had, and how much excess they could do with their food.
Wow. Just not just because they had Debs as a guest. It was actually because they had to feed.
Yeah. Did you taste? You had the cocktail in the beginning. That was the Prince Regent's cocktail, which was incredible.
Had rum in it. Is that right?
It had practically everything in it.
Don't say a word.
I wasn't going to say anything. It's green tea.
Oh, okay. Green
pineapple.
Tea.
Yep. There was something called maraschino in it, which was his favourite tipple at the time.
Oh, okay.
Sort of cherry liqueur.
Cherry. Yep. Amazing.
I had whiskey, brandy, prosecco.
Wow.
Sorry, this was in one drink?
In one drink.
So no mixers?
I suppose the green tea and
the green tea.
That was the healthy
pineapple bit. Pineapple juice.
One of your five a day, right?
Why green tea then? Is it just
exotic? He had a passion from Chinese because the inside of the pavilion is oriental. Think about it. So that sort of ties in with that.
Okay.
We served it in a great... Did you see? In a great big mixing bowl.
Mixing bowl, yeah.
Which you thought was quite appropriate.
Very cute.
They've just put a head in it.
Do you see now why it's me who gets invited to these lovely things, Jason, and not you?
No.
Yes. So what else is going on to reach the town? I know that you are encouraging members of our fair republic to go along and help out, do a bit of volunteering.
Oh, indeed. Well, every time we come, we ask for volunteers. We're always looking for volunteers.
Excellent.
The best thing that's happened recently is we've managed to get our sideboard finished. Sorry, the kitchen dresser, I should say. The kitchen dresser is complete. So that was taken apart. There's a story, I should tell the story about the kitchen. Mm-hmm. Right. It was completely derelict in 1984. The roof had come in, the pigeons had got in, they'd been pooing basically up to about waist height. So the first time Nick went in there, you could see, it was in the summer as well, about this time actually, and it was moving, it was ever so slightly moving.
What was...
The pigeon poo.
Why was it moving?
Because of the heat. It does that in the heat.
Okay.
Just a very slight.
Yeah, so slight movement. Okay.
So it was incredibly run down and covered in droppings.
They had to scoop it all out of wheelbarrows and empty the space out.
Now, that's some dedicated volunteers
right
there.
We've got amazing volunteers. Gradually, the whole place has been restored over, since 1984 onwards. Mm. And it's only now that we're starting to use it as a kitchen. So it's taken that long.
So you've rebuilt the kitchen
last part, the kitchen dresser, had to be taken out in bits, and it's all been put back together again. It looks amazing. It's incredibly large.
And
it's
large as the back
here. Is it the original dresser?
It was first put in 1829 when the house was built.
And it survived all this. That's incredible. What's it made out of then?
So it's in sections of wood.
Right.
So they took apart all the sections and put it away somewhere safe while the roof had collapsed.
Oh, I got you. Okay.
And then put it all back together again, recently, now that the roof is completed.
And how long did it take to restore the kitchen dresser?
Oh, that's been months as well.
Yeah, okay.
A long, slow process.
And is that mainly done through people coming in and giving up their time for...
We have one day a week on a Thursday where people come in.
That's incredible.
And we have one volunteer, I should say, Tom is in his 90s. Comes in every week on his bicycle. does his bit, goes off again. He has operations and things happen to him. But every time he just, he might take a week or two off, comes back again.
Excellent. What is it that makes him attracts him so much? Is he just a...
He says it's because he wants to have something in his calendar that he sort of has to do.
Yeah.
Oh, right, okay.
That it's nice to do. Mm-hmm. That's what he likes.
Which is why Debs comes to your events.
So how did you become involved? Because obviously you're at the helm with the cooking, hence the hence the chef's rights. How long have you been there?
I came in for an exhibition, and I fell in. Yeah, well,
you couldn't get away.
Well, you know what attracted me was just that the place was run down, and I thought this place needs some love. This place needs some care, and so I came in and started plastering actually originally.
And now you're the chef.
Now I'm the chef.
Were you a trained chef, or was it just?
I've been interested in cooking all my life.
Right.
In Amsterdam, I lived in Amsterdam for 12 years, and we sort of set up an illegal restaurant that only opened Saturday and Sunday.
Wow.
Oh, okay.
And through that, it was just about eight of us just set up our own restaurant, and that was an incredible learning experience because we didn't know what we were doing in the beginning. But after a while, when you've got paying guests, you just have to learn.
Because I haven't been to one of your food events. What kind of food do you prepare? We recognise it today.
Yeah, absolutely. But it always has an 18th century flavour to it. Right. So I have old cookery books that I cook from. And I use the recipes they would have cooked in that kitchen.
Do you eat seagulls at all or not?
Actually, saying that. No, I've just been looking for the cookbook now. There is a recipe for sparrow dumplings, if you fancy it.
I'm a veggie, unfortunately, but
I do cater veggies.
Right.
So we get lots of celiacs, vegans, vegetarians, and I make sure that I can find something in the book.
So there are recipes for...
Absolutely,
yes.
Absolutely. A lot of the poor were vegan, if you think about it at the time.
Yeah, I guess they would be.
Because meat was something that only the upper class
people
had, and dairy. Excellent. So in terms of upcoming events, so your next one in September, your next Dine Like a Servant, sold out within 3 days.
Sold out within 3 days.
Quite quicker than Glastonbury, isn't it? Fantastic. It's brilliant.
Better food as well, probably.
And how often do you do them? Every few months?
I do them every few months. Yeah. We've got a special one coming up for Halloween, which will involve ghost stories set in dark places in the house. You've seen some of the house.
Yes,
there are other rooms
that
are very spooky, very derelict.
Wow.
That we will have... There were talks of having one of our volunteers maybe laid out on a table, and as people come in, she'd rise and give a story. Don't know if that's going to happen, but it's a lovely idea.
Those old seances they used to have.
Seances have been talked about. Excellent. We haven't made the plans yet, but what will happen is people will have one part of the dinner. Mm. They'll be whisked off to part of the house in the dark, have a ghost story, come back for the main course, whisk off to go and come back
for the pudding. What kind of food will you be making? Like a Halloween thing?
Yeah, I haven't got for the menu. I know I'm going to have pumpkin on it.
Of course.
It will be autumn themed.
Yes, yeah.
But I've not planned it yet. I've been looking through some ideas today, actually, for it.
And has there ever been any paranormal activity there?
No. Oh. We did have one lady that came round and said that she could feel the housekeeper in the housekeeper's room, but
That strange food disappearing incident when you were there.
When I was there, and the wine. We've only got just under a minute left, sure. Paul. We are going to share all the details of Regency Townhouse. Pictures and things probably been flashing up as we've been talking. If people want to get involved and come along and give up some time volunteering or want to come to an event, just go onto the website and contact Regency Townhouse.
Yeah, and what I say every time is just go into Google and type in Regency Townhouse, and YouTube videos will come up, Twitter will come up, Instagram will come up. I do the social media as well, and I just try and get our message out. Because we just want people to come and experience this house.
Sounds a fantastic experience, and you know, if Debs would let me, I'd like to go.
We'll see about that.
Oh, thanks, Mrs.
Great. But no, it's been a pleasure having you back.
Thank you very much.
Come back and tell us how it's all been going. And yes, thank you very much for tuning into the first half. See you in the second half.
Cheers, Paul. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Welcome back to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove. This segment doesn't have any food in it, so Debs has gone.
Yeah, unfortunately. Sparrow dumplings, and she left.
She left to
scoff them down.
Last thing she said, sparrow dumplings.
Oh, yeah!
She was gone. But instead, we have Andy. Hello, Andy.
Hello. I don't eat sparrow dumpling.
No.
No.
Sparrow dumpling, that sounds... Yeah. Anyway.
We're having a history show this week. You may notice the theme. We had Paul from the Regency Townhouse in the first half with the sparrow dumplings. But to continue that local theme of history, we've got something quite exciting. The local historian who's digging up information about Brighton's conjoined sisters.
Oh, okay.
Who's after getting a plaque. Actually, enough from you. Yeah. Shall we ask him on?
Let's have him on.
Alf, would you care to join us?
Alf!
Hello.
Hey!
Would you like to just regale us with a story of the Hilton sisters?
You want me to just ramble?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, okay.
Ramble somewhat meaningfully.
Okay.
Try and get sparrow dumplings in there somewhere.
I think you've asked too much.
No, okay. that's a tall order.
Okay. Yeah. I thought I'd ask.
Yeah. I discovered the Hilton twins last year.
Yeah.
They were Pygopagus twins, which means they were joined at the hip.
Right.
That's a good word.
That's impressive.
Pygopagus. They were literally joined at the hip.
Pygopagus.
Yeah. Okay. And they they became vaudeville, massive vaudeville stars in America. They earned, throughout the 20s, I reckon they earned about $2 million. They were massive stars. It's hard to appreciate quite how famous they
were. Sorry, is that converted to now?
No,
that was $2 million at that time
in the 20s.
Then money, not now money.
Blimey.
Yeah.
That's serious money.
Yeah. But they've kind of been forgotten here.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And they were in the film Freaks, the 1932 Todd Browning film Freaks.
Yeah. I've seen that.
Yeah.
They were really, in a film full of freaks.
Yes.
They had these really cut glass English accents, I seem to remember. And it was like, that's even, sorry, I don't know why I said that, because it's a kind of an American film, and they all seem to be quite American.
Yeah.
And then there was these conjoined twins with very posh English accents.
When did they go over? What age?
They went. They got there when they were about 11.
11?
Yeah.
So the first 10, 11 years they were born and bred in...
They were born in Riley Road in Brighton.
Yeah.
And my whole thing I'm doing is trying to get them a plaque. And I've had the OK from the commemorative plaque panel, which is associated with the council. And now I just need to raise the money to get the plaque made.
Yeah.
I'm in touch with their niece.
Oh, okay.
Because they had two siblings, which they didn't know about. And the youngest sibling, Ethel Kate, was adopted up north, and she never knew. But 4 years ago, her daughter, she had two kids, and her daughter, Sheila, discovered that the Hilton twins were her aunts.
Wow.
So that she didn't know about that they had siblings because they had been adopted. So how come the Hilton twins were, you know, because they were conjoined, they were like an act that somebody could exploit?
Yes.
Exploit.
The mother, Kate Skinner, she rejected them. For a number of reasons. Partly she was quite young and unmarried, and any disability was seen at that point in time as like a moral judgment on your character. And possibly because they were conjoined, she freaked, basically. I refused to feed them. And the midwife who attended the birth was actually also the landlady of the Queen's Arms around the corner.
Oh, right.
And she agreed to take them on.
Right.
Okay. Well, that's putting it nicely. She bought them off Kate, to be honest.
Right. So she was wow.
And then financially exploited them throughout their lives until their early 20s.
So they were exploited.
They were completely exploited, yeah. You could buy a postcard. Right. They lived at for a year above the Queen's Arms, and then they lived for a year above the Evening Star up by the train station.
Yeah.
And in both places, you could go in and pay some money and see where they were joined, and buy postcards and photographs and stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
They were
from about the age of three, they were toured around the UK, then toured around Europe to Australia, and then on to America.
And of course, being young, they had no idea that that was not normal.
No. Mm. It was only when they were about 23 that, for a completely different reason, they got taken to see a lawyer. And the lawyer asked to see, because Mary Hilton gave them up, well, passed them on like furniture when she died to her daughter.
As property, yes.
So they were being controlled by the daughter and the husband.
Right.
None of that, which was legal, of course, but, you know, two little girls, what are they going to do?
It's slavery,
And when they were about 23, they get taken to see a lawyer, and the lawyer says, can I speak to my clients on their own, please?
Mm-hmm.
At which point they spill the beans, and he sneaks them out the back to a hotel, never have to go back to the Myers Hill again.
Right.
Which is when they kind of, they start their lives, really.
Did they get their money back from these people? Or
They settled for a really small amount of it. They settled for $100,000, which, you know, was still a lot back then.
Yeah.
And then they continued to... Did they perform?
They carried on performing, because that was all they knew.
Exactly.
They were petite, they were pretty, they could sing, they could dance, they could play musical instruments. They carried on performing straight after they got their freedom. Yeah. They formed the Hilton Sisters Revue.
Oh, wow.
They danced with Bob Hope. And they were friends with Harry Houdini. Yeah.
Right.
Okay. And he taught them how to mentally separate so that one could be doing something and the other one could be doing something else.
Shall we explore that something else?
You can.
Okay.
But play the piano and make pies.
Yes. Make sparrow dumplings.
Well done. That's top
did it.
Choice.
I did it.
Yes. Well done.
But in 1933, because the film Freaks flopped.
Yes.
Because it was so controversial, because it featured people... It was set in an American sideshow, and it featured people with physical disabilities, so real people with real unusual bodies, not actors with prosthetics and makeup. And it was just too controversial for the American public.
I guess
and
it got banned, didn't it? Was it banned?
It was banned in the UK for 30 years and just kind of dropped in America. So that was 32. In 33, they came back here.
Yeah.
And they did that was their UK tour, the last time they were back in Brighton.
Right.
And they appeared for four nights at the Hippodrome.
Did they know this was their hometown?
They knew they were from Brighton, yes. Yeah. But they also came back hoping to meet their mother.
Right.
Only to find out that she died when they were four.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
so she didn't last very long at all.
No, she had two more children and died complications of childbirth of the last child. Yeah. But part of my problem was actually finding out where they were born. Because there was a lot of conflicting evidence online, and it wasn't until I got hold of the original birth certificates that I could prove that it was 18 Riley Road. Sorry, number 18, if you get a lot of attention now.
We're going around there, straight now.
No, we're not.
But they're lovely, So, they've agreed to it.
What kind of plaque are you? Is it one of those blue plaques?
Yeah, I was hoping... Joined.
That's a brilliant idea.
Yes.
I don't think that's going to be possible. I think they all have to be the same shape and the same colour and you know, exactly the same.
Fabulous idea, though.
Yeah.
Can they each get a plaque?
I actually asked their niece, Sheila, if she, you know, if she thought that was tasteful, and she did. She said she thought it was nice because it represented them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's so to raise funds for it?
Yeah.
Why should? I personally think it's a brilliant idea. But is there any reason why our viewers should make a contribution?
The Hilton twins had a really tough life, and they were really famous, and they seem to have been kind of forgotten in Brighton.
I want
Brighton to kind of re-embrace them.
It is very Brighton to embrace people.
Yeah, who were slightly different.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm doing walking tours.
Yes.
And I've done some already.
Uh-huh.
So taking you through the streets. So obviously we start at the Queen's Arms where they lived above there for a bit. Okay. Taking you through the streets. I've got another set of conjoined twins in there. I've got some midgets and some giants.
There's a web address. Simple web address to access this, isn't there?
TheBrightonTwins.co.uk.
Right. We'll make sure we'll
Yeah. So you can donate to the plaque. You can book on a walking tour. Or you can just send me nice messages.
Or you can join Facebook recipes.
How much money is a plaque?
Well, a plaque is about £1,200. Right. But
you got that.
I'll have it. But there's going to be scaffolding on top because of where it's likely to be placed. Right. So that's roughly another 300, I'm guessing. Yeah. So yeah. I'm going for 1,500.
So is there any, apart from Freaks, are they on any other film?
Yep, they in 1952 they did Chained for Life, which they put
Jolly
all...
Jolly tight.
Yeah, they put all their money into it. It was a courtroom drama featuring... Okay. It's kind of based on their lives, but it's Dorothy and Vivian Hamilton. Mm-hmm. And the idea is that one of them has committed murder, but how do you punish one half of a conjoined twin?
Okay.
Intriguing.
And they threw
premise.
All their money into it, and it financially ruined them because it bombed.
Oh, shame.
Because it was... I mean, if you like B-movies, it's great. It's an exploitation B-movie.
It's available as...
It's on the YouTube. Yeah, it's on the internet. Okay. It's been kind of released for public domain. Right. It's got three great songs in it as well.
Excellent. So there's a bit of their act in it, is there? Or are they just playing... serious characters.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's kind of done in flashbacks, so you see them perform and sing.
Right. With the show rushing on as it is, in summary, walking tours worth doing, find out about them on the website, please donate to the plaque, because it sounds like it's a brilliant thing
we
to do.
We help the Hiltons.
Yes.
Exactly.
Thank brilliant. You very
Thanks
much for coming
thank
on
thank
the
you.
Show. That's Tune the in again next week for more brilliant stuff. Can we top this, really?
No. Thank you.